Right. Good evening. It has been quite a long time since we met last time, right? Can you hear me? Someone please unmute and give a feedback. Can you?
Yes.
Okay.
Yes, sir.
Is it clear? What about my sound quality? Is it clear?
Yes, sir.
Okay, right. Right. So before we start today's lesson, I must tell you something because we already finished two units. There may be something missed in the second unit. That doesn't matter. I will explain. So we completed first two units, fundamentals of ICT and fundamentals of a computer. And also I started to explain the third unit as a video tutorial. Maybe half of the particular unit has been finished. Maybe some basic things need to be explained. They are not actually hard. Sorry. So I tried to explain the unit number 3 as a video tutorial, not like as an online class. So that will be continued. Maybe in the last week I didn't publish any video. But maybe in the upcoming week, there may be one or two videos will be published for unit number 3. So unit number 3 will be taught as a video tutorial. Then unit number 4, you know, that is also one of the units to be taught for second term. Unit number 4 is something related to electronics. So there we have to study something about physics. So it may be a little difficult if I explain that as a video tutorial or maybe as a online class, because there may be something to be written on the board and we need to understand some basic ideas. So it would be better to study that in a traditional class, because we have to do some practical and everything. So it will be taught once the classes are started. So I have to wait, or you have to wait until the classes start. So today I have to start the next unit, which means unit number 5, right? Unit number 5 that may be managed with the computer as a online tutorial or as a video tutorial, because there we have to understand things related to computer. So since it is related to computer and computer programs, it may be easy to carry on as an online class or video tutorial. So I have decided to start that particular unit as an online tutorial, right? So from today, maybe we need 5 or 6 classes to finish this unit number 5. So before our classes start, I hope to finish this unit number 5, right? Okay, without much introduction, straight away we can start that particular unit. You know that unit is called operating system. So I know most of you know the word. You are familiar with that word because we all use smartphones. We all use tablets, most of us use computers. So since we are familiar with these devices, the term operating system actually not a new word for us, right? So that may be a familiar word. Maybe for some of you, that word may be a new one. But for most of the students, even though they don't understand that word properly, they heard about it and they know the devices which use the operating system. And maybe some of you may know the importance of operating system, right? So it's going to be operating system, right? Let's see. Right, this is the unit operating system. So first of all, I must tell you something. In unit number two, we talked about hardwares, computer hardwares or hardware components. So now you all know hardwares are physical components. They are tangible things and they have a physical appearance, right? So hardwares are very important because now we are conducting this video conferencing because of most of the hardwares, right? We use web cameras, we use microphones and some other devices. Right, we use some other devices too. But at the same time, we have to use some of the softwares or some of the programs in association with these hardwares. Hope you remember one of the sentences which I mentioned earlier when I explained about hardwares. So I mentioned that hardware without software is useless. So if you want to use a hardware, definitely you have to use some software. For example, if I want to use anything, maybe a printer, maybe a scanner, or even a web camera, there may be some softwares which have to be associated with that particular hardware. Otherwise, hardwares are just objects. They do not function anything. They are just physical things, right? So with that particular idea, we can start this, right? So first of all, I must tell you, before we start the word operating system, I have to explain the term software or programs. So I know that most of you have heard this word software, but we have to understand the meaning of that particular word because that is important, right? So let me explain the word software. After that, we can take that, right? We can take the word operating system. First of all, we have to understand the word software. So see, we use so many softwares in our day-to-day life. Even now also, we all are using softwares. Even Zoom is one of the software, right? But softwares are used for various purposes. Let me explain the word, or let me introduce the word software in a very brief manner. Actually, software is a set of instructions which direct the computer to perform some tasks. I repeat my definition, and after that I try to clarify, and I try to prove that, or maybe there is a definition, so I have to prove everything, right? So I mentioned that software is a set of instructions which tells the which directs the computer for performing tasks. There may be another definition. Look at the other definition. Both of them seem to be same, but maybe the second definition has some kind of an elaboration. So better to understand the second one also. Set of instruction which tells the computer three things: to what to do, when to do it, and how to do it. Right, set of instructions which tells the computer what to do, when to do it, and how to do it. So let's take some time and understand the definition, because even though they are definitions, we have to understand. We cannot memorize them, right? So I explain with a simple idea. Look here. So we all know that a computer has a shutdown button, right? So there is a shutdown button in our computer. So what happens if I click that particular button, so shutdown? We all know that the computer will be shutting down, right? So when I click on the shutdown button, it will be shutting down. So see, when we click on the shutdown button, the computer will be shutting down. How it's possible? Because computer is just a machine. When I click on a specific button, it understands my instruction and straight away it responds. For example, if I ask you to write something on your exercise book or in your exercise book, you all can write that, because we are human beings. Whatever I give as instructions can be understood by you. So you understand my words, you understand my instructions, and immediately you respond. Right? So understanding a human language is actually it's not a miracle thing. That is nature. But here it seems to be a miracle one, because it is a computer. When I click on a button like shutdown, right? So the computer understands my instruction, and straight away it terminates. It shuts down. How it's possible? So now you should know that actually this is nothing. It's a software. So the person who developed this software might have given some instruction to computer saying that when someone clicks on shutdown button, please turn it off. Have you understood? I repeat that idea. The person who creates this software gave some instructions to computer saying that when someone clicks on, see, until I click, nothing happens. Now, see, look here. I pointed on top of that button, but nothing happens. But when I click on that particular button, computer responds. So that particular person who wrote those instructions clearly gave to the computer about how to shut down. But the problem is we are unable to see the instructions. We all can see some colorful buttons and some words and everything. Those instructions which that particular person gave to the computer are hidden, because those particular people or that particular software company wanted to hide, because you know there is a high competition in between those companies. So that's why those instructions are hidden. Have you understood? So now try to compare my definition with this particular example. So look at the first one. Software is a set of instructions which directs the computer. So here there are instructions. When I click on shutdown button, computer will be directed towards shutting down. Even you can take the second definition, and it suits with that particular example. Look at that. Software is a set of instructions which tells the computer what to do, when to do it, and how to do it. So look here, that particular person wrote instructions in three categories. He gave instruction like answers for this question, what to do. What to do? Shut down. We have to shut down. Those instructions are given. That person gave instructions as answer for another question. What is it? When to do it. When to do it? Look here, now the computer is still working, still running. But when I click, it happens. So that is the idea, right? When to do it? When someone clicks. And how to do it? That is also there. See, when I click shutdown, you have experiences, right? When I click on shutdown button, your computer will be gradually turn it off, gradually shutting down. You can see some sort of messages on the screen like your window is shutting down or something. you are able to see such messages because of the instructions that the particular person gave as answer for this one, this question, how to do it. If the instructions are given in a different format, like shutting down immediately, your computer can be shutting down within a second, within a fraction of a second. That is possible, right? But your computer takes some time and then it shuts down because that person gave instructions like that. That is how to do it. Have you understood? Not only for this, right? For anything. I took shutdown as an example. You can take anything, even while you are playing game, you know that, right? When you are playing game, you know there are activities going on. Your game will be, carried out according to your expectation. So on because of these instructions, right? So this is very simple. Try to understand. Software is nothing. It is a set of instructions. Remember that phrase, right? Set of instructions which directs the computer to perform tasks. Or in other words, or in another definition, if I take another definition, software is a set of instructions which tells the computer what to do, when to do it, and how to do it, right? So hope you understood the definition. Definitions are not actually matters, right? But we have to understand, because whenever we learn a new thing, we should actually know the real meaning, right? So if you have any doubt, you can ask later. Maybe in the middle of the class, I can give some time and clarify, right? If you have any doubt, even at the end of the class, you may be given some time, right? So wait until I give some time to ask questions if you have any doubts, right? Okay. So I hope that you all understood this simple definition for software, right? Okay. So let's move to the another one. This is important. We have types, right? Software types. There are two types of softwares. We have system software and also we have application software. These things are actually important for examination. Even when we talked about hardware, we categorize them as five, right? We have input devices, we have output devices, we have storage devices, we have processing devices, and we have communication devices, right? So we have five types of hardwares. That was in unit number two, right? Now we are talking about softwares. There are two types of softwares, system software, application software, right? So before I start these two types of software, I must tell you one thing. Among these two softwares, system, application, that system software, gets the majority, or it has more influence than the application. Maybe application software also important, right? Even though that may be slightly bottom part of system software, but may be important, but among these two, system software is important, right? So let's see about system software. Right. The software can be divided into two types, like I mentioned earlier, system software, application software. So I'm not going to define the word system software. There is no need for defining. Even we cannot define the word, but we have to understand these three softwares which can come under system software. The first one is operating system. Even, you know, that is our unit title too, right? Even though I started off with software, the unit is all about operating system. So operating system is a kind of system software. I will explain, right? Wait. Then we have another system software called utility. I will explain this maybe at the latter part of this unit, not now, maybe after three or four classes, we will check that. Then we have another software called translators, sometimes called language translators. This also be taught at the latter part, not now, right? So we have three types of system software. without any introduction for system software, I straight away listed, right? But don't think that they are, new things, so they are a little bit harder to understand. But I will explain everything one by one. So operating system, utility, language translators. This I'm showing this diagram only for getting some idea, right? So you don't need to worry about these new terms which you are seeing on the screen, right? They will be very simple when I explain them, right? So there is no issue at all. All you have to do now is to read and get that idea, right? So that the functions, so their purposes are not important enough, right? Okay. On the other hand, we have application software. Here I have listed some application softwares. Don't think that we have only, 5 application softwares. There may be hundreds, maybe even there may be thousands, but we have listed only 5 of them, but there may be many. This diagram actually extracted from your book, right? So I have extracted from your book, but there may be many examples, right? I will give some other examples when I explain about application software, right? So at this particular moment, you should know that there are 2 types of softwares. The first one is system software. The second one is application software. We have 3 system softwares: operating system, utility programs or utility softwares, and third one, translators. On the other side, we have application software. It may have so many examples, right? We have hundreds of examples for application software. Here we have some names: word processing software. I will explain about word processing, spreadsheets, database, computer games, web browsers, right? Wait until we take that application software part, right? Okay. So this is a small diagram which shows the entire thing about software. It is a small diagram, but which shows entire part of this this unit software, right? Okay. So let's take them one by one. Right. So let's. This is the very first time that we take this word. You heard this word, right? Most of you have heard this word, but you don't know what actually the word operating system is, right? So we have to understand that one, right? So now we all know one thing, that operating system is a software, because in the previous diagram I clearly illustrated that, right? So operating system is a software. In fact, it's a system software, right? But we should understand the role of the operating system in the computer. We should understand the function of the operating system, or how the operating system functions in each and every computer, right? So remember these things. Operating system may do many things, but generally operating system does 2 major things. Like I list or display here, operating system controls your hardware components, right? So let's see, you have so many hardware components in your computer. Like I mentioned earlier, you have web cameras, you have mouse, keyboard, monitor, speaker, you have printer. So all these hardwares must be coordinated, must be organized, must be controlled. Then only you can have a smooth, function, right? So if they are not coordinated, if they are not controlled, there is always a collision, right? There is always a problem between them. So that operating system, or this operating system, does that particular idea, does that particular work. So operating system controls the hardware component, right? There is one more thing that the operating system performs, that is controlling the application software. Wait until I explain the word application software, because up to now I just introduced the word application software, but I didn't even explain in a very brief manner, right? I just introduced or shown that word, right? Okay. So now you know that application software is a kind of software that must be controlled. Maybe in the next slide, I will explain about application software. Then once application software is explained, then everything will be very simple, right? So operating system performs two things in our computer. It controls all the hardware components in order to perform smoothly in our computer. At the same time, that operating system controls your application software, right? Okay. The other important thing is every computer must have at least one operating system. You may have more than one operating systems. There is no issue, right? But at least you must have one operating system in your computer. Without an operating system, no computer works, right? So even if you have a desktop computer, even a laptop computer, I will explain this smartphone also, right? Even smartphones must have operating system. Maybe in the upcoming slides, we will discuss smartphones must have operating system. So without operating system, no computer works. But you know, without Zoom application, your mobile phone or your computer works. Without a game, your computer works. Without your Viber or without WhatsApp, your mobile phone works. But without operating system, no computer works. So now you can realize that operating system is very crucial for each and every computer. Doesn't matter it's a laptop or desktop or smartphone, it is important, right? So remember these things about operating system as an introduction. First thing is very important, operating system controls all the hardware components as well as it controls application software, right? Every computer must have operating system. Before we continue this operating system, I must tell you, I must explain the word application software, then only you can understand, right? Okay. Unlike operating system, right? Unlike operating system, application software actually is not must for a computer or for a mobile phone or for a tablet. But if you use application software, you may have some benefits, some advantages. For example, okay, I define the word application software. After that, I take one or two examples, then only you can understand. Application softwares are developed for performing some specific tasks or fulfilling some specific needs or specific purposes. One application software doesn't fulfill all the needs. So it is not a generic kind of software. It's a specific software. For example, let me take a simple example. See, your Viber is one of the application software. Now just compare your Viber with my definition. So Viber is developed when software is created. We use the word develop, not create or not design or something. Softwares are always developed, right? Not don't use other words like create or design or form or other words, right? Software development, right? So let me come to the point. So when Viber is developed, there is an aim, there is a purpose. What is it? What is the purpose behind that Viber development? It is simply, it's a communication. It's a communication. Your Viber can perform only communication activity. Can you use your Viber for typing a letter? No, you can type a short message, but that doesn't mean that it is for typing a letter. So Viber is not developed for typing a letter. Can you perform some calculations in your Viber? No, right? That is not the purpose for developing Viber. And can you edit some videos in Viber? No. So Viber is developed only for communication. Even take a look at your WhatsApp, same purpose. WhatsApp also developed for communication purpose. It may be visual communication, verbal communication, maybe text, exchanging text messages, but overall it's a communication. So let me take another simple example, then you can understand. I try to take some example for application software. We all know, some of you may not know, but it doesn't matter. PowerPoint, even the ongoing presentation, ongoing class is created in PowerPoint, Microsoft PowerPoint. PowerPoint is what? It's a software. But PowerPoint is an application software. Why? In PowerPoint, you can be able to present your ideas to the audience. Now look here, I am the presenter, right? I keep going, right? I am the presenter. I am presenting something in PowerPoint. You all are audience, you are watching, right? This is the only thing which I can do in PowerPoint. I cannot type a big letter. I cannot perform calculations. I cannot play a computer game here, right? I cannot edit videos here, because this PowerPoint is an application software. It is developed for fulfilling only a specific task. What task is this? It is presentation. Have you understood? So let me take another one, another simple one. So see, even look at that Zoom app. You all use Zoom app. What is it? It is application software. Why do we use Zoom app? Can you play a game in a Zoom app? No, right? Can you play it? Can you type a book there? No. Can you do a presentation there? No. With the help of Zoom, I can explain my presentation. But that doesn't mean Zoom is for presentation. So why Zoom? Why was it developed? Again, one purpose. What is it? Most of you know that, right? What is it? It is video conferencing, right? Hope you know the word, because we in the unit number one, we discussed about video conferencing. For conducting a video conferencing, we need some requirements, right? Hope you remember my requirements. So I talked about computer is important, internet is important, and also you have to have a web camera. At the same time, there must be a software, right? Do you remember I mentioned that as a communication software? That is Zoom, right? So Zoom is only for video conferencing. Even though it looks like an online class, actually it is video conferencing. Your videos are, hidden, right? You are muted, but still it's a video conferencing, right? So this is the idea. An application software is developed for fulfilling specific tasks. Remember, one application software doesn't fulfill multiple tasks, multiple needs, right? So now you can understand why I did mention, or why I mentioned, that we have thousands of application softwares. Like I already mentioned that we have thousands of application softwares in computers. What's the reason? It's not one, it's not two, it's not hundreds, it is thousands. Why? What's the reason? We are human beings. We are people, right? Each and every day, maybe each and every hour, our needs are increasing. From time to time, right, we people have so many needs. So we needs are always increased. So when needs are increased, there is a software developed in order to fulfill that particular need. Look here, why did they develop Viber? Why did they develop WhatsApp? Or why did they develop Zoom? Without Zoom, you can communicate, right? Without Viber, you can communicate. Why? Because if you don't have Viber or WhatsApp or Zoom, you know, communication seems to be very tough. But when you have such softwares, you know that communication becomes very simple. So this may be the reason for developing thousands of application software. We have numerous needs. So sometimes the application softwares which are in your computer may be different than the softwares which are in my computer, because I may have different needs, you may have different needs. Maybe some softwares are common for you and me, but I may have, because if I am interested in some areas, I definitely install those softwares. If you have some different interest, definitely you have different softwares, right? So it's up to them, or it's up to you to have application software, but definitely you cannot count them, right? There are a number of application softwares. Okay, so remember these points. I will show you some of the application softwares. Look here. You have MS Word. Have you heard MS Word? MS Word is a software for inserting text and maybe for editing and everything. We can call them as word processing, right? Word processing means we can type and make some changes processing the word. Letters are changed or letters are formatted, edited. That is word processing. MS Word is one example. There may be many word processing software. MS Word, in unit number 6, we will learn about MS Word, right? This I'm showing these names only for getting some idea about application software, right? So just remember them. You don't need to even understand those things, right? Just remember the names. MS Word, word processing software. Actually, it's a category, typing category. MS Word is one of the product. Like, see, if it is a shoe, right? Shoe is a category. There are so many companies produce shoes, right? Bata produces shoe. DSA produces shoe. So there may be so many, shoe companies in the world who can produce shoes, right? So similarly, here word processing software is a category. MS Word is one of the word processing softwares. There may be many, right? In unit number 6, I will list down other word processing softwares, right? Then, you know, Photoshop. I hope some of you know this, because it is one of the popular image editing software, photo editing software. Again, there are a number of photo editing softwares, but Photoshop is one of them. In fact, it is one of the famous photo editing softwares, right? Then I already explained about this PowerPoint, MS PowerPoint. It is a presentation software, okay? There are so many presentation softwares, but MS PowerPoint is one of them. Then MS Excel is another software for calculation, right? It is for calculations. You can do any kind of calculations here. Doesn't matter you belong to financial sector, or you belong to statistical sector, you belongs to mathematical sector or text, any kind of calculations can be performed by spreadsheet. That is a category name, but MS Excel is one example. There may be many spreadsheet. This is our unit number 7, right? In unit number 7, we will study about spreadsheet software. In unit number 8, we will study about presentation software, right? These are logos, right? The first one is logos, actually not important, but I put it here for getting some general ideas or knowledges, right? So this is MS Word, this is Photoshop, PowerPoint, Microsoft PowerPoint, this is Excel, right? So hope you all have some idea about application software. Like I mentioned earlier, operating system is must for every computer, but application software is not must. But now you all realize that if we use application software, we can get benefits. See, if you don't have Zoom in your mobile phone, you are unable to participate in this video conferencing. If you don't have Viber in your phone, you are unable to communicate with the other person. if I don't have PowerPoint in my computer, I cannot present this idea, present this operating system to you. But with the help of Microsoft PowerPoint, I'm able to explain everything to you. And if I explain only verbal without showing or without displaying this text and photos, it may be extremely difficult to understand, right? So application softwares, even though they are not compulsory, they are very useful for the users, right? So hope everyone understands. Right, then try to understand this diagram. This can be asked, or definitely this can be asked in exam. In fact, it was asked in the past once or twice. It was asked in the final paper. Look here, I filled all the circles, but in examination, they kept them as blanks. They put A here, B here, C there, and asked you to find out A, B, C. But here I have written all these words. Look here. We have three circles. Try to understand this idea here. This diagram shows the relationship between hardware, application software, and system software. I can say operating system because there are system softwares. There are three system softwares, but among them, operating system is must, right? So this diagram shows the connection between three things: hardware, system software, and application software. Right. Look here. Inside of this inner circle, we have hardware. There is a reason. I will explain. In the middle circle, we have operating system. Right. We have system software or operating system. Doesn't matter. Right. You can take as operating system. In the outer part, in the outer layer, we have application software, right? So now look here, in the middle part, you have operating system. In one side of OS, right? One side of OS, you have hardware. On the other side, you have application software. So why did they put like this? Even you may think that hardware can be written in the middle circle, maybe application software can be written in the inner circle, but actually that is wrong. If you write like that, it is wrong. Why? What's the reason? See here, like I mentioned earlier, system software, in fact, operating system, right? Operating system controls two things. What are the two things which are controlled by an operating system? The first one is hardware, right? So operating system controls the hardware. And also the operating system controls what? Application software. So look here, if operating system controls both hardware and the application software, definitely that operating system must be in between hardware and the application software. Am I correct? If the operating system is not in between hardware and application software, then how can it control? So look here, I am here, assume I am here. I have two people in both sides. On the right side of me, there is one person. And also on the left side of me, there is another person. So if I'm in the middle of these two people, I can manage or control these two people. But suppose if I am sitting next to two people on one side, it may be very difficult to control the two. Maybe one can be controlled because that person is very, very closer to me, maybe beside of me, but maybe the other person is far. That may be the simple reason here. Operating system is located inside or in between application software and hardware, right? Because operating system controls the other two, right? So don't worry about systems or utility or translator. Now take this system software as operating system, right? Even some books say, argue that operating system is similar to system software. But we have two more system softwares, utility and translator. But among these three, operating system is must, right? So get that idea. Operating system controls both these things. That's why it is sitting in between these two applications, software and hardware, right? So inside of this inner circle, I have added some hardwares, keyboard, mouse, monitor. There may be many. And also under system software, I have listed all the three system softwares, utility, translators, operating system. But remember, the inner circle, in the middle circle must be operating system. Even without writing system software, you can write operating system alone. That is correct, right? You don't need to write system software. You don't need to write utility. You don't need to write translator. Only operating system can be written. That may be okay. You can write only, right? On the outer side, you have application software. Look here, I have written some of the application softwares, right? Not many. Word processing, spreadsheet, presentation, photo editing. Have you understood? Right. Right. So this is the connection between these three words: application software, system software, and hardware components, right? Right, then right, let me take some examples for operating system. This is also important, but you have some experiences with these things, but I have to explain, right? There may be some students who don't know these words, or even don't get some idea about these words, right? Let me explain. So there may be so many operating systems used around the world, right? But all these operating systems can be categorized into two things. Actually, these are not types, but when they are used in a device, we categorize them into two, right? Because of those devices which we use, we take them as two. Look at them. The first one, used in PCs, right? Some of the operating systems are developed for using in a computer, right? So those softwares are not used in mobile devices. So they are specially developed for using in a computer, right? So I have listed, I will explain. Some of them are developed only for using in mobile devices. So, you know, we have mobile devices, right? We have smartphone, that is one of the mobile devices. We have tablet, also one of the mobile devices. So they are mobile devices. They have small screen, less powerfulness. So definitely the operating system must be weightless, and there may be some different features. But on the other hand, those operating systems which are developed for computers must have some different features, right? Because they are used in computer. You know, computer is a powerful machine, so they have to run very fast. And also they should do so many heavy works, right? You know, this simple ideas, video editing or photo editing is something which is heavier than the other activities. So definitely you need some softwares for both PC and mobile devices, right? Okay. So let me take some of the operating systems specially developed for using in computers. You know this word, right? Microsoft Windows operating systems. This is one of the famous operating systems in the world. This is from Microsoft. We all know that Microsoft is a giant in software industry. It is one of the biggest companies in the world. It is located in United States, right? So Microsoft released so many softwares, not only operating system, it releases so many. But now we are talking about operating system. So Microsoft operating system is known as Windows operating system. But that Windows operating system may have versions. Take a look at the versions. Versions means, so if you take a book, assume you have a book, right? Say someone publishes a book, right? Like your history book or something, right? One person publishes a history book. Maybe after some time, maybe after 1 or 2 years, some new things can have to be added in the book because, you know, history always created, right? History always, renewed. So you have to add everything from time to time. But what happened, that particular book has been published this year. Maybe that particular publish can be taken as first edition. In book, we used to call that as edition. Maybe after a few years, maybe after 1 year or 2 years, if you have new things in that particular history, you have to add those new things in your book. You don't need to, change your book completely, right? Completely. You have to adjust only a few things. If there are some mistakes in your book, you have to correct that. If there are new things, you have to add them. This is a kind of modification. So once the modification is done, you know, the book has to be published again. That is the second edition. So like that, you may have so many editions. Second edition, third edition, fourth edition, fifth, it goes. Right? Similarly, if a software is developed today, it has certain features. But what happens when the time goes on? Assume you have a Zoom here, right? You all are using Zoom. It has features, right? What happens after a few years? Assume that years are passed, right? We are in the year of 2023 or something. You know, in 2023, you don't have the same need as you had in 2020. In 2020, you had some needs, but things changed when it comes to 2023. So if your Zoom is old, none of us likes to use Zoom. So definitely that Zoom software has to be changed. It has to add some new features, new characteristics. Then only people prefer, right? So definitely the particular company which developed Zoom think about this issue, and definitely it will modify. When it is modified, that is another version, right? So time to time you have versions. For books you have editions, here for softwares you have versions. For time to time Microsoft released so many versions. Maybe at the beginning you have Windows, maybe before Windows 95 also you had so many Windows versions. But I have pointed some of the famous Windows operating systems. So Windows 95 is one of them, Windows 98, Windows XP, Windows 7, Windows 8. Nowadays we are using Windows 10. Maybe after some time there may be another versions released. So time to time Microsoft add new features. When they add new features, there is a new version releases, right? So these are Microsoft Windows operating systems, okay? Right, so since the time is running out, right? I just want to finish at this point, right? Remember, we have to study other operating systems like Mac operating system, Ubuntu and everything. So right. Right. So if you have any doubt in today's class, ask me. You can unmute your microphone and ask me if you have any doubt. Now you have the privilege to, right, you unmute your microphone. If you have, we have covered a small part because we are unable to see each other, right? So that's why I cannot go faster. So I'm taking my time to explain everything slowly. So if you have any doubt, ask me. I'm giving some time, maybe minutes or two, right? So if you have doubt, you can ask. You don't need to tell your name, right? That's not needed, right? Just ask the question if you have. Okay. So since you don't have any questions, so since none of you ask any question, I hope that you all understood today's introduction. I can call this as introduction because I covered only a small part today. But like I mentioned earlier, I have to take my own time because even though we don't have enough time to study, we have to go slowly because these are something which are not familiar with us. Even though we use in a computer, we have to understand them in a proper manner. Maybe in the next class, one or two, there may be some new things taken, right? So it is better to go slowly. So hope you all understood the today's lesson. So with this, we can conclude today's lesson, right? So better we can meet in the next class. Okay, thank you.